Well, hi there guys and girls, and welcome to another episode of On the Bank Angling. Today's episode is coming from the Dorset Stour, and the guys are going to be lure fishing for predators. So if you're interested, tune in and see just how they got on.
Basically, I'm having a walk down the river looking for likely holding areas for pike, perch. I'm just trying to work the swims through where I think they'll be. And basically, if I'm not getting any takes or any indications that there's fish there, then I can just move on. And then when you've got, you know, a nice overcast day like today, it's nothing better than having a nice walk down the river. Yeah, hopefully we catch a few. So I've just caught my first fish of the session. Nice little jack pike of about 4 pounds. Just using small little jigs. And yeah, great fun on a small rod. Yeah, put this one back now.
River's quite coloured, isn't it?
So. Yeah, it's really coloured. So I'm just really looking for a bit of slack using high vis lures. I'm trying to get takes from these little fellas.
Sweet.
So yeah, I'll put this one back for you now.
Great start for John, and although he had a few more casts in that swim, he couldn't get another bite. Part of the joy of lure fishing though is travelling light and be able to fish a lot of swims, so the lads moved up and down the river in search of more pike and hopefully a perch. Will they get one?
Hooks come out easy. Nice little, what, another 4 pounder? 4.5.
John showing us the way.
Yeah. Second fish. Just a few swims now, so. Yeah. But yeah, just happened to drop on this one. Just taking it second cast, I think. So
shows when you find them, yeah. Doesn't it?
Once you get on them, it doesn't take long. Yeah, put this one back.
Let's have a look at the jig.
I'll show you the jig. Check number two. That's what I've been using. It's just a small Xander shad actually. It's kind of in between the perch and the pike ones, so it's a little, it's sort of medium size. And then jig head and line trace. Obviously I don't want to be losing any pike, so I've just got the wire trace for a bit of protection. Really light line, but yeah, good fun.
Well, with no more bites coming from that swim, it wasn't too long before the lads were on the move again. They were searching for anywhere where there was a bit of slack water or a snag to fish to. These can often be fish holding areas at this time of year. The next swim they fished, however, would contain an entirely different species.
This one on a little jig right in against some reeds, weighed it 1.5 pounds because we weren't sure how big it looks. Quite big, but yeah, it's nice and full. Yeah, hopefully there'll be a load more of them there, but yeah, there we go, we're gonna put it back now. Sweet. We'll be right back.
jig. Really chuffed with it. It's not massive, but it's something. Stunning colours on it. I don't know if you can see, but blood red fins and then really dark stripes down it.
They're awesome fish, aren't they? Yeah, catch on little lures.
See the jig that I'm using? Very, well, similar colours to the perch.
A little minnow one.
Yeah, so, yeah, really chuffed with that. I mean, what, 3/4 of a pound perhaps? But yeah, hook just dropped out. Really nice. Chuffed with that.
Pike of the session on jigs.
Yeah, gone for a slightly smaller one this time on a fluorocarbon leader. So yeah, just proves that you can land them on fluorocarbon. Yeah, probably a little bit bigger, perhaps 5 pound this one. So yeah, as long as they keep going in that direction, should be good. Cheers.
With the action on the jig slowing down, the lads couldn't resist getting out on the main river to try and catch a chub. This turned out to be a complete waste of time, however, and it wasn't too long before they were back in the mill pool after the perch.
Ah, oh, oh, ho, ho, Stevie, oh my days, oh Steve. Oh, what have you done?
Yes.
What have you done? Oh my days!
That's your 2+er.
Go.
If not 3.
Okay, so the chub fishing didn't go to plan, so we decided to come back to the mill pool, first cast, and it's a 2 pound, 1 ounce perch. Well chuffed.
Quality fish. What did you catch it on, Steve?
Just a big lobworm.
So, we were jigging all over their heads all morning.
Well, fact, I knew there were pickings in here.
And that's the kind of perch you want to catch. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Well done, Steve.
No, not this way.
What a cracking perch for Steve. And it looked like some of the smaller perch were out competing the larger perch on the jigs. But that didn't stop John fishing with them and catching some lovely pike.
What's got there then, John?
Small little jerk.
Yeah.
Smallest I've had today.
Nailed again.
Yeah.
Well, let's see what it took. A sort of like fox red minnow thing. Nice, mate. Nice. In the swim, which would normally be bank. What do you reckon?
Well, pike number 5, yeah, on another jig. The last pike shredded my jig that I'd been using all day, so I was a bit disappointed, but I've changed and I managed to get another one, so I'm quite chuffed with that.
Absolutely, yeah. Smashing it, aren't you,
yeah.
On the jigs?
So, I've never caught as many pike in one day, but I mean, I know they're only small, but yeah, I'm still happy to get a bit of action on the rod.
Nice stuff, man. Hopefully that big perch or that 20 grabs it in a minute.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah, could happen.
So, a cracking result for John, catching 5 pike and some really nice perch for the other lads. Just goes to show, if you keep mobile on rivers, you can catch plenty of fish. And jigs are definitely one of the ways to do it. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys, and until next time, tight lines.